Hello and welcome back to another episode of Your Drone Questions Answered. I'm John Dickow, here to find the answer to your drone question that you submitted. Today's question is, what is the clientele for photogrammetry or mapping services when it comes to drone mapping? Today I have with me Dylan Gorman. He's the founder at Pilot Byte. Dylan, thanks for joining me today.
Appreciate being here. It's a pleasure.
First, I want to give you an opportunity to just kind of introduce yourself, talk a little bit about Pilot Byte and a little bit about your drone experience, especially when it comes to mapping.
Yeah, absolutely. So obviously, my name is Dylan Gorman. I've been flying drones for coming up on 11 years now. Professionally, it's been about six, mainly focusing in drone photogrammetry and mapping. And actually, well before Pilot Byte existed, I had a few DSPs, drone service provider companies that I ran. Sold one of them to a software company that leveraged the 2D and 3D maps that we were creating for commercial real estate and a lot of progress updates for construction. I managed basically their drone division for about a year and 8 months. We carried out anywhere from 150 to 200 flights per week underneath my management. So we captured a lot of data, all mapping, photogrammetry data. I left in December of 2022, so just last year, really focusing on shifting into doing education. One of the things that I realized running an organization of that size with well over 100 different contract pilots is most of them didn't have that foundational knowledge or understanding of how photogrammetry and mapping really work. So oftentimes we'd get data that would come back that wouldn't really be that good. So I dabbled with the idea of just putting out some technical educational videos on YouTube just for fun. And lo and behold, 2 years later, some of those videos have blown up. One of them literally just hit a million views last week, which was pretty cool. And the one question that I always kept getting asked was, hey, can you teach me? How can I learn about this? What are some resources that are out there? And I kind of thought to myself, well, when I first started out doing this stuff, I had no idea what was really out there, what you could really do with drones, what were the commercial applications of drones. So I decided to start putting out some YouTube videos, and then this year, I've been 10 months on my own doing Pilot Byte, where it's an online education platform. So similar to Drone Launch Academy, I have a few of my own courses just taught through my expertise of doing this for the last 6 years, working with surveyors, engineers, architects, construction companies, people that leverage this data every single day. To the point where now, like I said, I've got an education platform, I have my YouTube channel, and I'm doing in-person workshops. So helping companies, doing consultation, really building the foundation of mapping, modeling, photogrammetry, for really anybody, people that are just starting in the industry and people that have leveraged this technology for a long time, but just want to get a deeper foundational understanding of it.
That is awesome. That's really cool. And so I'm glad we got you. You're the right guy to answer this question. Let's just get into the meat of it a little bit here. Our audience, we're learners, but people who are beginners and may not know exactly what photogrammetry is when it comes to drones. Can you just kind of briefly explain what the idea is behind it?
Yeah. So photogrammetry requires really, you don't even have to have a drone. It's just the concept of extracting three-dimensional data from two-dimensional images. So whether you're using your iPhone or a drone or a DSLR camera, right? If you capture enough photos with enough overlap of an object, you can extract 3D data from it. The most common 3D data that we're familiar with is models. Think like video games or virtual production or any of those simulation, like ArcViz simulation. We see those really pretty meshes of buildings, objects, whatever else it may be. From there, it can get a whole lot more complex where you can extract contour data. You can do NDVI reports for agriculture. I mean, there's a whole plethora of things, but just the basics of photogrammetry is extracting that three-dimensional data from two-dimensional images.
Perfect. Thank you for laying the foundation. And that kind of leads to my next question, which is the meat of the question. I think it's fair to say why somebody would order that kind of service. And so talk to me a little bit about the type of people, the type of industries that could need this type of drone photogrammetry service.
Absolutely. Honestly, the photogrammetry, mapping, whatever you want to call it, I believe it's a fundamental skill to harness because it can be leveraged in so many different ways. Whether it's asset inspection for telecommunication poles or transmission and distribution lines, right? The stuff that we need, like what we're using right now to communicate through the internet, somebody needs to inspect it. So creating a three-dimensional model of it is not just practical, but is necessary to keep up with the maintenance and making sure that they're following protocols. When it comes to designing cities, right? They need to get the existing layout, the urban footprint of what's already there, and leverage aerial data, whether it's from satellite or from drones, and recreate a three-dimensional model there. Other applications, which is primarily what I leveraged it for with my clients, was for progress updates in construction. So whether you're doing volumetrics, figuring out the size of stockpiles, whether it's sand, dirt, whatever kind of materials on site, tracking the progress of the vertical build of sites, you know, not just having the earthworks of moving dirt around the site, but also watching the foundation get poured and all these other steps come into play. And I'll give you a real world example for a client that we leverage this for. At first, you know, they were pretty hesitant about leveraging photogrammetry services that we were providing them. At the time, this was, almost 5 years ago now, they were paying us about $175 every single time we went out. Again, very early days, still kind of figuring everything out. Over the span of the entire project, I'm from Florida, so Publix is a big grocery chain, especially in the Southeast. So they were developing a Publix. And obviously, there's several different parties involved when it comes to developing a construction site. You've got the plumbers, the electricians, the actual contractors that are building the foundation and people that bring in the dirt. Right? You have all these different people working on a site. So keeping track of everything that is going on is a huge task, which is why you have a project manager there on site every single day. But they can't see everything that's going on. So they hired us to start leveraging our drone services of providing these 2D and 3D scans of the site and track the progress. Well, one day during the earthworks project, and believe it or not, earthworks is very expensive. A site that I did a few years ago was about a 300 and something acre mixed use development. It was $17 million just to do the earthworks on. That's just to move dirt around the site on an existing place that has the dirt already. So think about on a much smaller scale, dirt is still very expensive. On this site, the contractor had lied, basically said, hey, we need more dirt for you guys to bring in, roughly about $60,000 worth of dirt for you guys to bring in. Well, client asked us, said, hey, can you guys actually go back in time and see how much dirt we actually had at this specific stockpile? Lo and behold, we went back 2 weeks, looked at the dirt, gave them just a rough report or estimate of that stockpile. And they took that report, the volume of it, presented to the contractor saying, hey, you guys actually have more than enough dirt. Why do you guys need more? And the contractor asked, well, how did you get that? And they said, we scanned it. Found out that the contractor was selling dirt on the backside of the project site and essentially lying to the developer. So that $12,000 that the developer had paid us over the span of, I believe it was 16 months or 18 month project that we were doing, paid itself. And I actually had a conversation with my old business buddy, that my old business partner from that old company that we sold, literally 2 days ago, talking about how that company still talks about that project and how we have saved them that $60,000 and how they want to start re-implementing drone data back into their projects that they're doing. So that is just a one real world use case of leveraging aerial maps, the photogrammetry and mapping in a construction sense. There's so many different verticals that you can get into, but that's the one that I know best.
Yeah, that's kind of amazing. That's one you wouldn't think about. I've heard about, you know, drones being used at construction sites and mapping out progress and locations and building models. But then also that was, I mean, what you explained there is essentially like an audit that saved them money. And so that's a whole other safety net that drone mapping service provided. That's amazing.
No, absolutely. And I've talked with several other construction companies, some off the top of my head, Core Construction, Ryan Construction, Turner Construction. Like these are some multi-billion dollar companies that are running operations, and having conversations with them a few weeks ago at Drone Deploy Conference, they were all talking about how they all had very similar instances that happened. And since then, they have implemented drones as a requirement for every single phase of the project. And even some of them, such as Turner Construction, they're not allowed to have their own internal drone program. They have to subcontract it out. And who are they subcontracting it to? DSPs. So being able to understand what this data can provide, what that value is, right? Everything is a value add, right? We're in a service industry. So you need to understand what your client is looking for, how you can solve a problem for them. And if you can solve that problem, it's going to save them money. It's going to save them time. But it's up to you to educate that client on what your capabilities are. It's not as simple as getting your Part 107, getting a compatible drone with any of these photogrammetry softwares and paying for and then expecting, you know, your phone to ring. It's doing the due diligence of getting that education just beyond your Part 107. Right? Getting that technical education, whether it's going through an online course or going to an in-person workshop or even just trying it out yourself, Right? There's a lot of free resources out there for you to learn from, but understanding how that technology works and then applying it for your specific client's use case, it's what's going to take you from an average drone pilot to a above average drone pilot. But even then, you can expand further on that as you learn, as you experiment, as you try out new things with this whole quote unquote reality capture world that we're getting into, built off of the foundational understanding of photogrammetry and mapping.
Yeah, you've already shared some really great advice right there, what you just said. Being able to communicate to a client the value of your service. And I know drone, to a lot of people, maybe not to us as much, but to a lot of people in the public, drones are still very new. In what ways have you been able to sort of sell that service? Or could someone in any kind of industry, any type of mapping, sell that?
That's a great question. And I always have to remind my students and people that I consult with that the drone is not the business. It's the solution to a problem, right? It can help solve problems. It's the service that you build around, not just the drone, but the service that you're providing, right? What data can you capture? But not only what data can you capture, what can you extract from that data that provides value to your customer, right? Because we can combine all of these different tools together, but if you don't understand how it works, and two, how it solves a problem, then you're just stuck with a commodity. Right? Something that can take cool photos and videos, which I think that's what most people associate drones to. However, the landscape is starting to change very rapidly, especially being at some of these conferences that I've gone to where they're leveraging drones for some crazy applications. And the foundation of it is the photography, the LiDAR, the multispectral cameras that exist on it. But it's all the foundation of photogrammetry and mapping, right? That's the core of it. What you can take from that raw data, extract from it, and apply it to solve your client's problem, that's what's going to be that differentiator.
That's great. People like you, the entrepreneur that leverages drones. So much of our audience are people who want to learn drones and apply it to their career or start a new career with the drone. You've done just that. And you've already kind of mentioned that it's beyond the drone by itself. It's beyond just learning how to fly a drone, but it's finding a certain niche. Can you expound upon that a little bit? Just share some advice for anybody in our audience who's hoping to add a drone into their career, whether it's starting a new career or into their current industry. What advice would you have to say to them?
I have two pieces of advice that I would give. One of them is something that I live by every single day. I actually have it tattooed on my arm here. And it is succeed through failure. Do not be afraid to fail. Keep trying until you figure something out. It's going to be tough. I'm 6 years into this professionally and it's still tough. Not easy, right? Sure, YouTube may make it seem that, you know, I'm living a great, easy life doing all these projects. But in reality, there's a lot of hard work that goes in before I actually fly the drone and even after I fly the drone. 5% of really the job behind a drone is flying the mission. Everything else is before and after. The second piece of advice that I would recommend is ask questions. There's no stupid questions in this industry. It's how I've gotten to where I am today. I've asked just about every dumb question that you can ask within the industry, and I still continue to ask questions from people that are more experienced than me, from those experts, whether it's an engineer, a surveyor, an architect, right? Well, really specifically the industry that I operate in. And you can apply this to if you're in forestry or you're doing transmission and distribution, or even you're just simply doing real estate photography. Asking people that are already in that position that leverage this technology and just asking and doing is the best way to break past that fatigue of trying to figure it out through just YouTube University or, you know, seeing a few guides online. So those are really the two biggest pieces of advice that I can give. And I guess really a third one that I could add is be patient. This stuff takes a while to really get a good understanding, grasp it, but then also be able to explain it. Because not only are you a service provider, not only are you selling to your client, but you also have to educate your client. No matter what industry that you go in that leverages a drone.
I really appreciate that advice. And from somebody in your shoes, you've clearly put in the time. That patience bit is important. Anything else you want to add, Dylan, before I let you go? This has been great.
If you guys want to learn more about what you can do with drones, check out my YouTube channel. Just search Dylan Gorman Drones, perhaps, and I'll pop right up. If you want to learn stuff in person, I'm hosting workshops all over the US. I'm actually just about at the end of my second tour. So I have some stuff on the West Coast and some stuff in Texas. So if you're interested in learning about photogrammetry and mapping, please attend my workshop. And for all of you that are listening, I actually have a special discount. If you use DLA25, you get $25 off of your ticket. And then if you want to learn about LiDAR, a little bit higher end of the side of mapping, but I do have some demo workshops that I'm still doing. I've got about 8 left of those for this year. So be sure to check out my platform. And then also my website, where you can find some courses and some other stuff, is www.pilotbyte.com. Love to help, educate, teach, do all the stuff.
We love that. We love the drone education. We love the educators. Dylan, we really appreciate having you out here on the podcast. We hope to have you back, but I'm sure we'll have more mapping questions. You could submit your own questions at ydqa.io. We will find the answer to that question, or find the person who can answer that question. Or if you're on the Drone Launch Connect community, go ahead, type it in there. We'll see it. We'll work for the answer. In the meantime, we'll see you in the sky.